हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू चैनल। आई एम आशीष। इन दिस वीडियो विल टॉक अबाउट द ग्रेट सेफनेस पेन। द वर्ड सेफनेस मीन्स इजली सीन। सो व्हाट कैन डिराइव बाय दिस वर्ड व्हेन आई से द इट कैन बी इजली सीन मीन्स इट इज ए सुपरफिशियल वेन, मीन्स इट लाइज इन द सुपरफिशियल फेशिया एंड इट इज द लॉन्गेस्ट वेन ऑफ अवर बॉडी। इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड द लॉन्ग सेफनेस वेन और सिंपली द ग्रेट सेफनेस। It need not mention the vein because it's of so much importance in commonly used term that we only say the great saphenous or sometimes we say the long saphenous vein. It's the longest vein and it is the word saphenous means easily seen. So what can derive? It is the lies in the superficial fascia and it's also called the long saphenous vein. So this is a brief introduction to the great saphenous vein and it's obvious it's the vein of the lower limb. Now we'll see about the course and the formation of the great saphenous vein. So before discussing about the theoretical part, let's move on to the 3D and see how the great saphenous vein is formed and what's its course to the femoral nerve, that's from the lower part to the above part of the lower limb.
So by the help of this 3D illustration, what we are going to do is to study about the course of this great saphenous vein starting from the toe to the upper part of the thigh. So let's orient the 3D model and see only the total veins of the lower limb. So what we have to focus on the right lower limb, and here are all the venous supply including the superficial and the deep veins. Now how will you distinguish about the superficial veins from the deep veins? So what we are going to do is to add the muscles on. So the muscles are added. Now the deeper veins will be hidden back behind the muscles and the only the superficial veins will be visible. Now let's focus on the dorsum of the foot. So here on the dorsum of the foot you can see a venous arch, so that is called the dorsal venous arch, which is formed by the union of the distal branches which are supplying the digits. So here is a dorsal venous arch on the dorsum of the foot. So dorsal venous arch merges with the medial marginal vein of the foot. So you can see the meeting point. So when the venous arch, medial end of the venous arch and the medial marginal vein of the foot merges, the great saphenous vein is formed. So the highlighted part here is the great saphenous vein. So the bulge on the medial side of the leg is called the medial malleolus. So it lies 2.5 cm in front of the medial malleolus, crosses the lower surface of the tibia. The front bone that you can see over here is the tibia. It crosses the lower 1/3 of the tibia obliquely, runs along the medial border, certain part posterior to it. So it runs posterior to the medial border of the tibia. It runs posterior medial to the knee joint. So this is the knee joint. It runs posterior medial to it. Then it ascends upward along the medial side of the thigh in through the saphenous opening, and by piercing the cribriform fascia, it finally drains into the femoral vein. So this was all about the course of the great saphenous vein starting from the toe.
I hope in the 3D you had a good overview of the great saphenous vein. Now what you saw in 3D we'll discussing in the theoretical part with very simplified way. Okay, so we have just 6 points to remember in the course and the formation of the great saphenous vein. So great saphenous vein was formed, as you saw, in the front of the dorsum, which there was some arch shaped structure. So that was the dorsal venous arch, and there was some joint vein that was coming from the big toe, that is called the medial marginal vein of the foot. So it is formed by the dorsum of foot by the union of the medial end of the dorsal venous arch and the medial marginal vein of foot. If you draw a simplified diagram, as you saw on the foot, on the dorsum of foot there was an arch, and this arch was meeting at the there to the arch there was a vein which was meeting at the medial end. This the vein was the medial marginal vein of the foot coming from the big toe, and when these two combine they form the great saphenous vein. This is the location on the dorsum of the foot. Now what happens, as soon as it is formed it moves upwards 2.5 cm in the front of the medial malleolus. Medial malleolus is a swelling on the side of the lower leg. Okay, so as you saw in the 3D, 2.5 cm in the front of the medial malleolus, and it runs upward. And after passing 2.5 cm in front of the medial malleolus, it crosses the lower 1/3 of the tibia obliquely. So the great saphenous vein crosses the lower 1/3 of the tibia obliquely. The orange part section that you see here is the signifying the great saphenous vein. So the lower 1/3 of the tibia it crosses obliquely, एंड रन्स पोस्टियली लिटिल पोस्टियर टू द और लिटिल बिहाइंड द मिडल बॉर्डर ऑफ द टीबिया. सो दिस इज द लिटिल बॉर्डर ऑफ टीबिया दिस साइड एंड दिस इज द मिडल बॉर्डर एंड दिस सर्फेस इज द मिडल सर्फेस. सो इट रन्स obliquely on the lower one third of the medial surface, that's it crosses obliquely on the medial surface of the lower one third of tibia and ascends a little behind the medial border of the tibia. So this was the its course till the upper part of the medial border of the tibia. Now after the tibia it has to reach the knee joint, so it lies posterior medial to the knee joint. Posterior medial to the knee joint, its exact location you saw in the 3D part, so it lies posterior medial to the knee joint. And it runs along the middle side of the thigh to reach the saphenous opening. Saphenous opening is also called the fossa valis, and it's a opening in the fascia to through which the great saphenous vein pierces and reaches the femoral vein where it finally ends. So after piercing the cribriform fascia, it drains into femoral vein. This was all about the course and the formation of the great saphenous vein that we discussed in a very simplified way. Now we'll draw the diagram of the great saphenous vein that you have to draw in the examination. So not me, it's basically about the diagram. So let's see. In the introduction to the venous drainage of the lower limb, I have told you already the trick to draw the venous drainage of the lower limb, but we're discussing it again. Now what you have to do, you have to draw a straight line. That is basically you have to draw H. So this way drawing the first small H. And taking the same line as a base, we have to draw one more H. The detailed video you can see in the introduction to the venous drainage of lower limb. Now we have to draw three more H, but in the opposite manner. Normally we draw H like this. Now we have to draw in the opposite side. So first like this, one H. Here we have the second. And little above this, we have to draw the third opposite H. Now we have to extend the first and the last line downwards and form a capital H. Okay, so what basically with the line here, we have the this arch, that's a dorsal venous arch. This is dorsal venous arch. I'm only drawing the simplified schematic diagram to explain the great saphenous vein. The exact diagram you can see in your book as well as in the 3D part I have already told you, and the introductory to the lower limb we have already discussed. So this is the dorsal venous arch. I'm not going to discuss about the other nerves. We're focusing just on the great saphenous vein. So this is the dorsal venous arch. It combines with the medial marginal vein, medial marginal vein of foot. And the great saphenous vein is formed. This is the great saphenous. It runs upwards. The course, exact course we have already discussed. And it pierces the cribriform fascia. And finally merges with the femoral vein. Okay, this is the course of the great saphenous vein. So we are highlighting the great saphenous vein. So this whole part here we have the great saphenous. Now this was just the course and the formation. Now we have to discuss about the tributaries of the great saphenous vein, and I have just a good diagram to help you remember the tributaries of the great saphenous vein. Meanwhile, if you are liking the video, please hit the like button and show support to our channel by clicking on the subscribe button below. Just remembering the tributaries of the great saphenous vein, you have to draw a stick diagram of a man. So we'll draw a stick diagram. So this circle signifies the great saphenous opening, and the stick diagram is the head of the man. This is the main body of the person, and he is standing on some stool. Okay, and it has two hand and two legs. Okay, the rounded curve part shows that it is situated posteriorly, and the straight line signifies it is anterior. Okay. The round part shows it is posterior, and the straight line shows it is anterior. So this is how we'll discuss about the tributaries of the great saphenous vein very easily. This here, the circle over you see here, this is the saphenous opening. Saphenous opening where the great saphenous vein ends. And we have to make just three hairs like this. So the head, the three hairs are present. These are the tributaries of the great saphenous vein just before it terminates into the femoral vein. So these three tributaries are the first is the superficial, external pudendal with the superficial epigastric and the superficial circumflex iliac.
At the commencement, we have the medial marginal vein of the big toe, which is signified by the stool on which the person is standing.
Then in the leg, we have the posterior arch vein and we have some communicating branches. And just below the knee, we have the anterior vein of the leg and the few veins from the calf. Now, we'll talk about the thigh. In the thigh, again, we have two tributaries. That is the anterolateral vein of the thigh and the posterior medial vein. Which is posterior medial vein is also called the accessory saphenous vein. So, in this diagram, the hand portion are signifying the tributaries of the thigh. So, this is the anterior and this is straight part. Straight line that is signified is situated anterior. So, this is the anterolateral vein of thigh. And the posterior here, we have the posterior medial vein, which is also called the accessory saphenous vein. The tributaries of the great saphenous vein in the thigh. So just before piercing the gripping fascia, there are three more tributaries which are signified by the mnemonic S3. The S3 stands for the superficial epigastric vein, superficial circumflex iliac vein, and the superficial external pudendal vein. So three hairs of the head that we made about the three tributaries that are called the S3, which are the tributaries just before piercing the gripping fascia. Now before termination, this is very important. You can make a hashtag or some VIP over here, because this is a commonly asked question, which is the last tributary of the great saphenous vein. So whenever somebody asks you which is the last tributary of the great saphenous vein, you should mark your answer as the external pudendal vein. So the external pudendal vein is the last tributary. Now we'll discuss some facts. How many walls are present in the great saphenous vein? As I told you in the very beginning, some walls are present in the great saphenous vein as well as other veins of the leg, but in the exact number is usual asked. So they range from 10 to 20 valves. And we have some very important valve which is called the saphenofemoral valve. So saphenofemoral valve is formed at the junction of the saphenous and the femoral vein. So this is the saphenofemoral valve. What happens in 80% of individual, there is a valve present in the external iliac vein as well. So the external iliac vein continues into the femoral vein. So in the external iliac vein, there is a valve present which regulates the pressure in the femoral vein. That's it decreases the pressure on the saphenofemoral valve. This happens in 80% of individual, but in 20% of the individual, it is absent. The external iliac vein, the valve in the external iliac vein is the absent. So what will happen? This sometimes there is increased pressure. This will act on the saphenofemoral vein valve and will cause the or lead to the varicose vein in the lower limb. So the last heading discussed is about the clinical. So venesection in case of emergency is done on the great saphenous vein, and the graft in the case of the coronary bypass surgery. So in the coronary bypass surgery, that usually two grafts that are taken are from the either from the great saphenous vein or from the internal mammary artery, IMA, or maybe sometimes from the radial artery. So this was all about the great saphenous vein. If you like the video, please hit the like button and do subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.